Originally started with the deer stuff, and then handheld Garmin, used those, and the operators were pretty resistant to working with them. The frustration was loading the maps, getting the maps, getting the right kind and shape or size of shape files, or right format, I guess is the right word, of shape files, and then getting them out there, getting them on the machine, and finding out they still didn't work. So a lot of back and forth to the woods. Once we got with the Maxi N, the files loaded a lot easier, a lot more user friendly, and the operators were more productive because they weren't so frustrated by the time. By the time you got them in some of the other formats, they were so challenging to get in. You wasted so much time that you lost everything you're going to gain from GPS.
Okay.
So just having them easy to load is. I think Maxi N, from what I've gathered, it takes multiple different types of shape files, so it's not you don't have to have this particular type and load it this particular way, so that makes it pretty nice. Shapefile is the so you have the units, usually you have a map file, which is either a geo-referenced aerial photo, or a topo, or a topography map, or a LiDAR map, and then the shape file would be the shape of the harvest unit. So, and then another shape would be the shape of the streams, and then a road would be another shape, road shapes, and then topo could be a shape as well. So these are all layers that you layer together, and to create a harvest unit.
Okay.
Yeah, so the challenge is being a logger trying to tell somebody something that you don't know what you're talking about. So tell them a specific file format that you need when you don't know what you're really asking for. That was a real challenge with the other guys. This stuff seemed to be whatever they're using. They use ArcSoft and ArcMap at the landowners we're dealing with, and those files seem to transfer smoothly onto Maxi N. Everybody's working off the same script, I guess, so to speak. So, from an operator's perspective, I mean, situation awareness. In the Northwest, we have lots of streams, and some are evident on the ground, and some are real evident on the map. So your location and position in relation to those streams, which we're trying to protect. That's a big thing for operators, and just situational awareness, where you're at on the ground. My perspective, same thing. I do a lot of recon, price a lot of units, and it saves me time because instead of going down to the boundary line, going around the perimeter of the unit, coming up to the road, verifying where the road is, verifying where the bad spot in the terrain is, I can walk more of a mid slope, and validate my distance with GPS from the bottom of the unit to the top of the unit with these handheld units now. So I can be 500 feet from the bottom line and 500 feet from the road, and be walking in the middle of the unit where usually the issues are for lift and those sort of things. With the machine, you can, I mean, there's other advantages for the operator, tracking production overlay on the screen. Knowing what trails have your production on, where your volume is, and area cut per day is a biggie for the operators. So now they can say, I've cut 5.7 acres today, and I'm gonna so from a production standpoint, I'm gonna try to cut a little more than that tomorrow. And then how much volume per acre, how much volume per piece and per stem, it's all right there all overlaid on the GPS now. The landowner likes to know where we've been and what we're doing, so they like the track file. So I will create a track file when the job's over of where we've been and what we've harvested. That track file is also helpful for the next guy. If he's going to follow the same track, we can pass that on to that individual, and he can see the kind of the planning, especially in commercial thinning. Some of the trails connect, some don't, but you can see that all before you get there with the forwarder with this mapping system. Well, I think there's a lot of value there probably with a forwarder. I've thought about it a fair amount, but we're still getting used to, trying to get operators used to getting comfortable with it, and using it and still getting comfortable with getting the maps in and then getting the maps out when you're done importing, exporting, and then try to juggle that to yet another operator of the system. So now I got another layer or level of importing, exporting. To my knowledge, I don't think there's a automatic syncing system through TimberNavi that would or MaxiN. That would be nice, either one, but now we have to, it's still a little cumbersome to load those maps on a USB memory stick, export them to the memory stick, bring them in, download them to a file, and that's kind of cumbersome. So I'm wondering how that would work. I think there's a lot of value for the forwarder operator to have the map that the harvester created, because we're a week behind, so the harvester's cut the trails a week ahead. The forwarder gets there, he's not really certain what the guy was thinking. There's a huge environmental uplift on that. Maybe he's not going to go down that longest trail because it's too wet, or the trail is down the lower elevation because it's too soft. He can look at the map and say, I'm gonna yard these trails that there's less volume, shorter distance yarding. When the weather dries out, I'll move the longer trails with the longer yarding. So it helps him manage the job site. It's probably both, because if it benefits me, in the end, it's going to benefit the landowner. I mean, if I'm more efficient, I'm going to be more productive. And it's definitely, as mapping gets better, as people get more comfortable with mapping products, another big advantage is having that map, in your field of vision all day long. You're going to lay things out better for the next guy, the next set of operating system that comes in. So, and your situational awareness is going to be better, because you don't have to triangulate to figure out where you are on the map. You know exactly where you are all the time, and you can quickly measure how far you are from this landing, how far you are from this stream, or how far you are from this RMZ, and it's just instantly there all the time. So you're forced to kind of look at that map and all day long, rather than having your back pocket all crinkled up and unlegible. Process, it helps you, it gives you a different tool to plan by. So you look at a flat paper map and you try to make a plan as best you can, but if you have GPS, it's quicker, it's more efficient in finding where you are and where, maybe areas of concern or where you should start, or areas and maybe mark areas on the map that are going to come back to, and so you don't forget that sort of thing and come back to that later when in a drier time. But it does help you manage the site for sure. Oh yeah, you can mark wet areas or areas of concern, those kind of things. You can put quickly tag those and mark those, and they're on the, and what's nice is they're on the map forever. So they're when I get the map, the final at the end of the harvest, I know that these things are there and these concerns are there. So if something comes up and there's environmental concern after the fact, because some of these audits we have are a year after we leave, they have these questions, and you go of what happened here and what you do here. So if we make these documentations on the map, they're digitally saved forever. Yeah. How it was operated, how it was. Actually, right now we're using, so we'll take multiple maps. We'll have an aerial photo current, an aerial photo 20 years, or maybe an aerial photo with georeference at time of planting. So you can kind of see how it was logged before, and you can actually overlay that photo, your unit over top of that photo, so you know where you're at in relation to the old skid roads, the old harvesting method. So you can reutilize some of their operations, which you would do naturally
right
when you got there anyways, but a lot of times you don't see it till after you're already in the woods. So yeah, and today maybe we need to, we have, so because we have a stream or a buffer that we can't do that, but looking at the history of how it was harvested before and being able to quickly pull that up on your screen and know here's an old skid road and I'm on it and this is where it goes, instead of getting out, walking to the end of it and saying this is where it goes. Mm-hmm. LIDAR is a big help there as well. So LIDAR mapping is basically the shape of the earth without trees on it. And some areas we have really good LIDAR. We'll put LIDAR map as an overlay the unit over LIDAR. So now you know where you're at in relation to these old depressions and shapes that are fit the physical earth surface. Mm-hmm. So you can maneuver around those and above those, and saves my operators saved a lot of time by it's called shade LIDAR. So the darker the the lighter the shading, the steeper the terrain, and he can actually see, look at the photo and say, I'm not going to be able to cross here, or I will be able to cross here. Previously, you'd have to walk down there, verify and validate. So GPS mapping helps keep the operator in the cab producing rather than on the ground looking around hunting. That's one thing about GPS mapping is you know when you're in the boundary, you know when you're out of the boundary, you know what side of the line you're on. A lot of times these units are laid out. I've been in the woods a long time, got a degree in aviation, actually how to read maps, and I've still gotten lost in the woods with a handheld map and a compass because I thought I was somewhere I wasn't, and I spent 10 or 15 minutes validating my position and still found out 5 minutes or 10 minutes later that that's not where I was. Thankfully, I wasn't holding a power saw or running a feller puncher, because that wouldn't have been good.
Yeah.
But so just having that confidence of knowing where you're at, I think the operators can actually focus more on productivity.
Mm-hmm. One less thing to think about.
One less thing to think about, one less thing to worry about all day long. And then you use that as a tool again to manage. So as you get comfortable with this mapping, you start to see other features that become helpful that you don't even think about. It just becomes part of, you know, another tool in your toolbox. Exactly, and that's exactly what the operators say. They're somewhat, a lot of times they're resistant to it, the new technology initially, and sometimes it takes a few months to get them comfortable with it, but once they get comfortable with it and they keep validating that how accurate that thing is, it's unbelievable that it's just like when it goes out or fails, they can't work without it. Mm-hmm. But they'd rather not.
Okay.
Maxien's seems to be a little more user-friendly. Just importing files and exporting files. It takes zipped files, which the other programs I've dealt with don't like zipped files. It takes multiple formats. So no matter, I have to deal with the land. So I don't provide the maps. I have to have somebody provide the maps for me. So I've got to communicate with them and let them know what map and what format I need. It's with Maxien, it's a simple step, because it takes, I wouldn't say every format, but it takes a lot of different formats, and I haven't come across one that it doesn't take.
Okay.
So. Area, it does give you acres. A lot of the other ones are still in metric hectares or meters, and so we get feet and inches, which is, I like that in North America, and that's what we live by. And then acres, which is what we can relate to. We don't have to do the conversion, so that's a nice feature.
Okay.
It's nice to measure something in feet instead of trying to do the conversion to meters. It's not a difficult conversion, but it's one more thing. And when it comes to area, though, acres is incredibly useful. That's what everything in North America that I've dealt with is all acres. So how many acres do you do today? How many acres are you on a trail, and how much volume per acre? So it's everything's related back to acres, not hectares. So.
Okay.
Yeah, the tracking layer on Maxien seems to be real accurate and real clear. So that's a good feature. And the mapping, I think the mapping software. So there's a lot of information. Every time you turn the machine, it has to reload because we run in track up mode. So whatever direction you're pointed, it reloads all the pixels. So all the photo, all the shape files are reloaded every so many seconds. So that Maxien seems to load that stuff relatively quick, and you don't have glitches and hangups in that cause other problems. So I think maybe the memory or something in that seems to be more functional than the others.
Mm-hmm.
So that would allow it to take larger files as well.
Okay.